Well, what? Hello, hello, everyone, and welcome to Let's Play Mafia 2. Okay, so I just installed the game. I'm overexcited because I played Mafia 2 like 2 years, 3 years ago, but I never quite finished the game. So this will be. I did like a chapter 2 or chapter 3, and then just I uninstalled it. I don't know why, but I think I had like a bad computer and it didn't quite handle the game. But anyways, right now gonna go with the story. I just messed up with the options a little bit, calling the audio just and with the graphics. So yeah, I know that Mafia 1 is going to be released, the remake, which is, I'm excited about that game too. I don't know if I'm going to play it anytime soon, because I'm going to finish Pillars of Eternity and Mafia 2. And then we'll see what kind of other game we got to play. So this is quite a change of scenery here with Mafia 2, because I'm used to Pillars of Eternity with swords and everything. I have to talk a lot in Pillars of Eternity. While in this game, it's just like, how can I say, like GTA 5, like watching the movie, something like that. So I really like these story-based games. So this is a story-based game. So enough talking, we're gonna go with the story. I just played that a couple of minutes, 10 minutes, just to see if the game ran smoothly. We're gonna start with a new game, and we're gonna play on medium, because I'm tempted to play on hard difficulty, but as I'm streaming, you know, I'm not as focused as I'm not streaming, because I have to comment on things. I'm not as focused, so I think I'm gonna go with medium. Medium is suitable for most players who are already familiar with action games, definitely like me. So let's go with medium. Yes, continue. Okay. Presents Mafia 2. Hey, it's so blurry, I don't know why. The screen is so blurry.
My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. Away from Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America. Never in my life had I seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment. The American dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop! Vito, this way! Throw me the bag! Stop! Hurry, shoot!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs and put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry, Vito.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war. And the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18. And anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Okay, chapter one. The Old Country. Sicily, July 1943.
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily. But we got hit by flak and had to bail out. Way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini's soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return a favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
Okay, so everyone is armed and ready for battle. There's one thing here on the audio settings. I want to bump this music a little bit more because it was too low. We'll go with 30. Voices are okay. So.
All right, Scaletta, take the shot.
Allora, traditori, pensavate di poterci prendere in giro?
There we go.
We gotta clear those balconies, Scaletta. Behind the sandbags.
More.
They're falling back. Let's move.
Let them try to leave cover.
Shit!
I'm dead! Shit!
GoPro! This guy's saying there's more troops headed this way.
It's all right. All right. You and Williams take out that machine gun nest, then find the prisoners. We're gonna need every man we can get. Ain't getting through this way.
Okay.
Looks like we found the machine gun! Watch it!
Okay, cover.
You got a grenade, Scaletta. This would be a great fucking time to use it.
Put a grenade through the window.
There we go.
Whoa!
Ooh, that's harsh.
Scaletta, you alive?
Yeah, it seems so.
Yeah, just about. Well, then get off your ass and let's move.
Rifle.
Whoa! Look at this.
I pick everything that I can pick. That's a pistol. Okay, we're gonna go with a machine gun. Press and left control. Okay. So are you stuck there? What am I supposed to do? I have no idea. Uh-oh. Stimulation. Seems like the game is stuck, guys. Seems that way, because this guy's not moving. Move! Move! Oh my god, I can't believe this. Come on.
On the stairs! They grease bomb. Catch!
Uh-oh.
Come on, asshole!
Must have the prisoners upstairs. Clear the second floor. Skeletta, you take point.
Uccidete gli ostaggi!
Siete morti!
Got him.
Got him.
The door's going.
Cue to kick open the door.
Arrenditi, o gli faccio saltare il sacco.
Oh. There we go. Oh.
Shit. Looks like we're going this way. Come on.
Shit! This balcony isn't gonna work! We gotta keep moving! Let's get inside!
Okay, this is much better, Rifle.
You're gonna die out there!
Avo dei fascisti! Arrivano avo dei fascisti!
MG and defend the town hall.
Get on that machine gun!
Okay. Killing everyone.
Dicevo al mio amico di stare attento.
Fregatene di fare attenzione, fai ciò che ti è stato detto!
This is it. Game over, guys. Game over. Thank you for watching. We got lucky.
Che diavolo sta dicendo? Chi si crede di essere?
Un'offerta da fare.
Ma è davvero Don Calò?
Cacetto. Un congè quando si amaretà come cucina.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noi altri del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete fidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to.
That's a powerful man. Chapter 2. Home sweet home. 2 years later, Empire Bay, February 8th, 1945.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Okay, so he's staying away from
Vito!
Cops.
Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
There okay. It is. Empire Ooh. Bay. Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods.
Okay, this game is old, but this game is beautiful.
Anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though. A drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito. Come on. Okay. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes. We're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal. What was it like over there, anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading.
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calò.
No shit. Don Calò. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah. And I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the US of A and to having you back home.
Okay.
Salud.
Ah, salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait, you mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is... Vito Scaletta. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later.
The situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl.
Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, whoa. Did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
So we are in debt to this guy.
You're welcome. Come on, Fred, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Okay. We got a taxi.
Here we are.
All right, thanks. Keep the change.
But the fire is so delightful.
Use the weather to navigate. Hello. Can I walk? There we go. Walk to your mother.
Vito! Is that you?
Hello, Mrs.
Mrs. something.
Vito? It is you! You look so handsome in that uniform. Your mother must be so proud. And what about poor Salvatore Montemaggiore? How is he doing? His poor mother was expecting him home a week ago.
Yeah, Sal joined the Navy. I'm in the Army. It's different.
Why don't you come inside and have some tea with me, Vito?
No, thank you.
You could tell me all about it.
Thanks, but I'm kind of in a hurry. I just got back, and I can't wait to see my mother and Frankie.
Such a pretty girl, that Francesca. It's a wonder she's not married yet. Well, say hello to your mother for me, Vito.
Of course, of course. So we're just gonna walk a little bit. It makes sense. This game is nice.
It's just one lousy beer.
And my dear, we're still okay, goodbye. He's drunk. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Let it snow. we can move a little bit faster.
Yeah, that's what everybody said when the Japs attacked.
Can we go this way? We can go, but I don't want to go. Oh, look at the planes.
Mr. Manah. You closing the shop?
Yeah, you know how it is. Can't afford to stay in business.
Wow, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, the war's not your fault, Vito. Who knows? Maybe when the war ends, I'll open up again.
Well, good luck then.
Hey, thanks, kid.
No problem. Whoa. So, they're fighting. Ti odio. I hate you. Okay, open the door. Go upstairs to Mama's apartment. Oh, that's a cat. Hello there, kitty. Oh, what the hell? Huh. Okay.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
So sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, la mangiare, che la tua volontà.
They're all saying different prayers. That's strange.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
Okay, so this is the kitchen area with a small dining table and a sofa. I mean, we are poor. Huh. What's in this room? Okay. That's the bathroom. Frankie?
So how you two been? Franny, what you been up to?
I still live here with Mama. I got a nice office job. It pays the bills, and I started paying off some of Papa's debts.
Francesca, we don't want to talk about that now.
So he was in debt.
How are you, mio bambino? It must have been so terrible. I was so afraid. I prayed for you every day.
I'm okay, Ma. I drove a Jeep most of the time. Sometimes I had a fight.
Okay. Damn, that's... We left when we were 18. We have a toy horse. So that's Jesus right there. Okay, so they are a religious family. So just gonna use the bed and go to sleep then.
I'll see you 2 in the morning.
Sleep well, mio bambino.
The next day.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
It seems like Vito doesn't want to stay in his place anymore. He wants the luxury. So it seems, I don't know. A leather jacket with shirt. So this is the only thing we have. Take the clothes.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe! You want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that, Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the Union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your pop. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
Go to Joe's place. So, first thing we do is go to Joe's place. Okay. Joe. And close the door, please. Don't want to leave the door open. Let's have him move on.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care
we'll get
if
the
you
money.
Gotta sell everything
hey.
You got. What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
asshole.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah?
Oh, yeah? So he looks like...
Come on, Junior.
Didn't
I'm
fight.
Gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on.
Wait,
hold
space to dodge.
Vito, please. There we go. You're making it even worse.
Is that okay? That's a hard punch combo. Okay.
Stop! Stop! Please, Vito. What are you doing?
Teach this idiot a lesson. Okay.
Please, Vito. This is
okay. Come on. Come on. There we go. There we go. Ooh. In his chin. That's harsh.
Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. You're gonna be sorry. The both of you.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants 2000. It all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
The money was different back then. $2,000 were a lot of money.
Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Of course, Joe could help you out. So go to Joe's place. $2,000. $2,000 of money were different back then. We have to go. Gonna follow the map. $1,000 were a lot of money. So, we're not gonna make the kind of money working at the port with this papalardo. Just gonna walk, not gonna rush things, like to take my time with this type of games. This game is no RPG, so it's more like a story based game. I like to take my time with this type of games, enjoy the scenery and everything. What's that guy on the minimap here? Oh, that's a cop. Okay. This floor? No.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
Okay.
Thank you.
This is bad, huh?
Nah, we ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
What the hell?
Disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting for you. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Okay.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. Now, you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
As you say.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
Shit. 3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I do is make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Okay. Since we're gonna go and pick those papers. So, don't be in the army service no more.
You think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's,
Who doesn't know what the hell, what the Jeep is?
Let me drive a while.
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
That's the brake, okay.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Uh-oh. The roads are icy.
Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Okay, if you say so. Just gonna wait here.
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it?
Option, audio, game settings, stimulation. Okay. The stimulation is much better than normal. You see on the map, it's right here. It's not far.
You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it.
Yeah. Well, don't want to crash the car. Since we're gonna go that way.
Ooh! Get a load of that baby.
Nice. That's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's.
Okay, so we're gonna steal it then.
Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off.
Okay.
Hey, Giuseppe, I brought you a new customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
retired,
Bay.
Retired, please. How are you? Papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
Okay, take the discharge papers.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Okay, who's paying? I don't know. Lockpicks? I'm gonna pay for them. Okay.
Grazie. But you can test it right now. Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock, she opens. Easy.
Where is that? Where's the lockpick? Oh, right here. Okay, move the pin. Okay, when it's green. Okay, nice.
See you around, Giuseppe. Se benedig.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry, you'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car.
So it seems we're gonna steal the car.
Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Steal the Jefferson.
Ah, oh, damn it.
Okay.
Possible Grand Theft Auto.
Oh. Police wants to arrest you. Okay, I got it. What now? Okay. I got it. Can we get a move on, please? Hello.
Freeze!
Oh my God! Anymore? Can we drive, please?
Close.
Copy that.
Yeah, well, it's not over yet.
Vehicle theft in progress. In pursuit of suspect.
Okay. Just gotta lose them. The vehicle is wanted by the police. Oh, please. Come on, get this thing over. Anymore? Come on. Oh my God. Come on, anymore? I'm gonna go. I don't know. Let's just wanted. I'm gonna go for that. She's so slow. She's killing me. What the hell is happening here? There we go, we crushed it, of course. We're gonna crush it. Can you go blue screen, please? Oh. The thing was on the square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right." Come on. No, don't get out. Oh my god, it's killing me. Come on. What the hell is happening? Vito, get in the car. Get in the car, Vito. What the hell is happening? Uh-oh. Oh, come on, get in the car. Oh my god, finally. Whew.
Watch where you're going!
Alright. Looks like we lost it. So how do you like the car?
Not just gonna go
too bad.
There.
Think I'll keep it.
Alright, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop.
Right there.
I know the guy who runs them.
Oh.
Here, park right here in front of the garage door.
Oh, we got that just in time.
How can I help you?
Change the plates. Okay.
New license plate. For you, no problem.
U.S. Zero. I want to put my... That's my. And I'm just gonna go with the G because my name is George. My birthday is at 28th of April, so a G, please. There we go.
There you go. Gave her a couple of.
Tune the engine. Car must be repaired. Can we repair the car? How can we repair the car? There we go. New rims. Since Joe is gonna pay.
Are you looking for a new set of wheels?
Might as well change the rims. I like these white ones. Place your rims. Improve the engine. There we go. Joe is going to pay.
Pick a color, any color.
I go with the black. I love the black. There we go. Let's go with the black. Rim, change the plates. Repaint. No, it's good.
Let's Thanks leave. A lot.
Okay. Got ourselves a new car.
All right, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He'll probably have some work for you.
All right, where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss it.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy.
What the hell?
My buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Come on, you stupid.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall,
oh my
average size.
God. Still again, oh my, I can't believe this shit. Not that fool. Okay, so you know what? I'm gonna end this part right here, guys, and then I'm gonna meet you right here on the next part after we have done with the car and repaired it. So I'm gonna see you in the next part, because this is getting annoying.